previously on the Inner Circle Dallas.
That shit Chelsea said? Bitch, why?
What'd she say?
When she was like, some, all y'all do is wear the same clothes or some shit like that.
Well, it's, I'm not gonna argue with you. It's not a back and forth.
That's fine. I don't need the production.
It needs to be done. So, you know, I don't need
it. I mean, it is what it is. Like I said, those bitches.
The only thing about my whole vagina is on social media. Like, if you wasn't trying to get niggas to want me, that wasn't the way.
After she came to see me, I just felt like maybe there was another side of her that I didn't know. I didn't know that she was this person that can be so humble. Because even though I'm bougie, I'm humble. And I didn't see that part of her. And when she came to see me, I got that part of her and I enjoyed that and I wanted to experience that.
I will forever be grateful for you. And I will be forever indebted to you for what you did for me.
No, it's not a debt. Did you feel like it was genuine?
I did.
Okay.
I did, and if I didn't, I wouldn't be here. That's my God's honor.
Facts.
That's
I know you.
They wouldn't pay you. For real. I don't even know how to.
Right. It'd be a totally different conversation. Right?
Hence the reason why I'm here.
So I'm glad that Khristina felt like it was from a genuine place when I was, you know, talking to her and was in the room with her and expressing my emotions, because I genuinely felt it. Like, in the moment that I was speaking with her, everything had went to the side and I just wanted to be there for her. So I'm glad that she knew that that was from my heart.
So I really feel like, you know, after I had a conversation with my friend, like, at the bond that we're building, I feel like you guys need to have that conversation before we go to this act. So, you know, I don't want to give any details. You get that from her because she has no problem. I've never experienced where you two are not able to provide any information that you want to say. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So I just want to make sure that you both are in the same place, express your feelings, and then we can go and have turn to come up.
So here's my issue with the whole situation. On any normal circumstance, Khristina would never have to tell me to have a conversation with Knyoka about anything that me and Knyoka are going through. However, you hit me up to go and kumbaya with Khristina, knowing that you had ill feelings, but you never said anything to me. But then you go and backdoor with Khristina and talk shit about me. I want to talk to you. Make sure we got
time. Alright, so let's pitch this scenario. So when you and Darius had y'all thing, you had a certain expectation out of him, right?
Yeah.
He knew better. So my thing is, me and Knyoka had a camaraderie before you and her did, before her and Darius with her and Devin. I feel like that whole kiki haha on the couch with you and her and Devin, it should have never happened. And because it did, yes, I lashed out of anger and I said what I said. But I didn't point her out. I went down the line. I got my lick back. So if there's a conversation to be had, she can come up to me and have a conversation. But I feel like she went on Twitter and said what she had to say. I said what I had to say and that's it on that.
To add insult to injury, like, me and Knyoka, we're supposed to be cool. But instead of you calling me and having that conversation about whatever I said, you decided to go on social media and clout chase and clickbait. And so when you made your comment, I responded. And then we had a conversation and it was supposed to be squashed because you was talking about shit that you had no business talking about. You didn't know. You knew your homework, sis. And then after that, you constantly bringing this shit up. I don't want to talk to you about this shit, sis. Just don't wear the same shit twice.
This is where I disagree though, friend, because just like you put your feet to the side to come to me, and we had the ultimate beef, you know what I'm saying? Like, it was, you said some hurtful ass shit, but you put that shit to the side to come to me, and I accepted that with open fucking arms. I think
but you were never close to me like that.
That's even more reason to go ahead and put aside the bullshit and be like, okay, let's talk about this.
No, because I feel like that expectation is higher with her because I didn't expect that out of her. I didn't expect her to sit down with y'all, number one, believe the shit that was said, because as you got to find out, Devin was lying. So I didn't expect her to sit there and believe the shit that was being said, and then on top of believing the shit that was being said, she engaged in the shit.
Come on now, this is your friend. If this is truly your friend and y'all had this friendship that was so amazing prior to us, then it should be no problem talking to your friend. So now I just feel like you trying to find a reason to be mad at Knyoka.
She didn't even give me an opportunity to be like, bitch, please. But she not only engaged in the shit, but then she went on to have a whole comedy show.
But she... Okay, well, it was mostly us being the comedians, and she was
but
just
that's expected.
But
to get now, she's like, yeah, that is true. I did see her saying it. No. Real niggas should have been like, because I'm telling you something. When Devin said with Darius, it wasn't too many more bitches he could have called you. You know what I'm saying?
I really think. Sister trying to find her way in this community. If that means starting issues with your own friend, hey.
So that was supposed to be my nigga with y'all. Like, y'all, no, come on now. You know what I'm saying? I had that type of expression. At least Devin was like, even with him being a newbie, he was willing to put his ass out there in line for his friend.
Right.
Put your ass in line for me as your friend. You know
what I can
saying? So.
But I still think y'all should have a conversation.
If she wants to have a conversation with me, she can.
I know she thinking now she found herself a winner. I know you fucked her on the counter right before you cooked the dinner. Yeah, I know you think about me when you kiss her. I left a taste in your mouth, cause she tastes me.
So, I'm glad that you have a very good impression of him.
Yes.
He is cute. He's very delicious. I like him.
I was like, when I heard Darius got a boyfriend, I said, I am flabbergasted.
I'm not flabbergasted, girl. Well, it's been a long time, so I've been kind of pacing myself, so.
I'm proud of you.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it. So, how are things going with you, boo?
It's been going good. Yeah. It's been chilling, working. You good?
Well, are you looking forward to the X-throwing event that we're going to pretty soon?
Yeah, Christina's X-throwing event, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm ready to have some fun with the crew.
So,
or whatever.
How are things with you and her going?
It's been going good.
Yeah.
What about, does she know about your boyfriend? How things with you and her been going? Like, she met him?
No, she has not met him, but I'm taking things slow with her because we're still trying to rekindle our relationship.
Lord.
So I'm really not trying to go too fast with her because, you know, I don't want to have to go through the same shit that we went through last year. But I'm trying to put a pause on it for just a moment and just kind of see how things go. So, I mean, it's all good. Okay. And the reason why she has not met him is because that she is not worthy to meet him. We are not, you know, in the same relationship that we once were before. I just don't feel like it's a good time for her to meet him, especially since the fact that she likes to go out and publicize everything about her life. She goes out to the clubs and she's meeting all these different people. Me, I like to keep it classy. I like to keep it conservative between a couple of close people, a couple of close friends that respect me and my privacy. So that's why I would rather not invite her in into my personal life, so that way she could be trying to meet anybody that I'm talking to. So, what about you and Chelsea? Because you know Chelsea's going to be attending as well. So, how are you with that?
What about?
I mean, I figured that perhaps there were some things, there was some tension between you and her.
Tension.
Last year, I think there was. I felt like there was. I don't know.
You know, my issue with Chelsea is that she felt the need to come for me in front of everybody rather than pulling me to the side like a real friendship. Like, hey, you know, my feelings was hurt when you laughed at this joke or whatever her issue was with me for her to come back at me. It was too strategic. You was too strategic about that shit. And I don't like shit like that. Like, bitch, you purposely sought out to try to hurt me when that wasn't the case when it came to me.
I mean, honestly, I don't have a problem with Chelsea. You know, I think people get it confused when you have an issue with them that you need to discuss versus you having an actual problem with them. It's not no problem. I can hang out with her. I could be cordial around her. I could be cordial around anybody.
That's cool.
I could be cordial around fucking George Zimmerman. I don't give a fuck. But if George I have an issue with you, I'm going to discuss it with you. So,
okay. I know you can't hold your own, so.
I'm worried, no.
Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah, I am.
Cool.
I am.
All right, well, let's go ahead and get ready so we can get out there.
Hi, it's Khristina from Inner Circle Dallas. Make sure that you like, comment, share, subscribe, and tune in every Friday for a new episode.
Drop that bag, say you rich, I'm trying to see some. Make it clap and hit a split, girl, let me see some. Work that baby, if it's sweet, I'm trying to see some. Twerk that out to the beat, girl, let me see some.
Hey,
some.
How you doing?
Nah.
How you doing?
I'm good.
Good to see you.
All right.
How are you?
I'm doing well. You know, living life.
Absolutely.
You know, I just find it weird that Christina's actually trying to reach out to me before her axe throwing event, because before now she's never tried to contact me or try to talk about anything. So I'm interested to see what this is about.
What you been up to,
though? Nothing much, you know, still trying to elevate up the corporate ladder and, you know, socializing with other people, trying to date. So, what about you?
How's that going?
It's going pretty good. I met a wonderful guy. We just actually went out a few days ago. He seems pretty cool, so I'm just trying to test him out and see how things work.
I just feel like, at this point, like, damn, like, we made up, you know, but I barely see you. So, I'm really not trying to... I don't understand. I don't typically give friends or niggas a second chance in any type of shape, form, or fashion, no situation. But I'm giving you a second chance, and I just feel like you're not really putting in as much effort as me.
I just came to pull you here to talk about it and see like where our friendship is and why I haven't heard from you.
Well, I appreciate you for contacting me. That means a lot. I just feel, though, that you and I, we've had history for a very long time, and I just think that for me and my best interest, for me to have a better clarity on what we are and our friendship, I feel like we just need to take a pause.
All right, you need your space, which makes absolutely no fucking sense, by the way. Then keep your space, and I hope your new friends is a better friend than me.
I don't feel like we need to try to further advance our level of growth in our relationship. I just think that because, you know, things were very sour, and I felt like our relationship in the past is very toxic, that we just need to just chill for a moment before we try to pursue
further. So you think chilling our relationship, what's the point of us having a relationship if we're not gonna actually build on it? Mm-hmm. Rather than correcting our errors in the past,
right,
and focusing on that. Instead, you want to pause on our relationship. Well, right?
I'm glad that you mentioned about correcting our errors, because I personally feel like over the past that you haven't been very apologetic for any of the things that you have done to me. I'm just being honest with you.
If you notice, a lot of times that we get into it, it's because of things that you actually do to our relationship.
Here we go fucking again. It's always my fault. Every time you and I try to have a kumbaya moment, you always want to circle that shit right around back to me. I'm always the one that's doing shit wrong. Why the fuck you ain't never said you did anything wrong? Bitch, own up to your shit.
So that's where accountability comes into play, is when you want to throw things back off on the other person for any situation rather than accepting your faults. And manning up to that and getting enough up off the ground and becoming that person that you should be. That nothing will happen. Literally every time we argue is because you've either told me business, you've done something to me, you've sided with other people, you've put me in a bind where you tricked me into coming to a situation where someone jumps on me.
I put you in a bind. I tricked your ass. You know what? I'm so done with this relationship already. I've had enough. I can't deal no more. Like, this girl wants to think that she is friend of the year. All right, well, you know what? I really don't want to argue with you about this. I just wanted to come here to hear what you had to say. And now that I've done that, I just want to be able to move forward from this. So I want to still have a friendship with you. I really do still love you and I care about you. But I just want you to respect my opinion on my side of how I feel about this.
Yes.
So can we do that?
Yes.
Okay. Cool. Can we look it up?
Yes.
All right. Then.
Let's do it.
I love it.
Well, damn. I'm gonna need a fucking.
Inviting everyone to my ass throwing event, and I just hope that we can just drink, turn the fuck up, and get a little aggression out by Jace.
Store is just not my style. I know we was just going all out so that we can be able to like enjoy each other and just support each other in this game, but no. Wrong event. Oh, you can't go past that marker. Good try, Chelsea. Good try.
The Axe Thorn event was so much fun. Never mind that the guy that was helping us was super cute. It was super funny. But it was so much fun. Like, we just forgot about all the BS and we were just having a natural good time.
Rolls out of here.
Woo! Oh! Now, you better go on with your strong
boy. X-Throne was really interesting. I don't think it's my type of activity to do, but your girl was killing it. Period.
Hey, girl, I have soda.
Every time throwing that damn axe was just like another chip off my fucking shoulder.
Oh my God, that was so good.
I cannot believe. You know what? Well, y'all did better than me because my ass could not hit a fucking axe.
Next time we need to have this
y'all.
So even though we had a lot of fun, I asked Knyoka, I asked my friend, did Chelsea reach out to you? And she said no, surprisingly to me, because of the conversation that I had with her. So yeah, I'm just bringing it up now.
I'm so glad y'all had so much fun here.
Yeah, thanks for inviting me.
I enjoyed y'all. Mm-hmm. But look, I'm some real shit. Darius, this is beside you, and for once, it don't have nothing to do with us.
Oh, God.
But man, I did talk to both of y'all, and I wanted y'all to talk, just because I went into any beef, any situation, to kind of be put aside. So, you know, I told you that I was gonna bring it to her, and I was gonna group y'all together, but I asked you to talk to her about it. She told me you didn't. So I didn't want it to be a surprise, but kind of surprise.
It's not a surprise. You told me she was coming.
I mean, but to talk about the situation.
No, I wanted Naomi to, when she was ready to address it with me directly, then. I don't feel like I had to come up to you.
Because I felt like you was being shady, and we supposed to be way cooler than that. Like, you was on some materialistic shit talking about some, oh, y'all wear the same clothes all the time, whoop de whoop.
I didn't say y'all wear the same clothes all the time. Yeah, but
that's how it came off, though. Like, I was like, wait, what, Chelsea?
See, here's the thing. Well, one, I feel like you decided to hash it on social media, so it was done there. And then two, you had a moment with Khristina and Devin where you fed into a lot of stuff, and you talked about my wardrobe. But I feel like I had a courtesy to wait until I got to you in front of your face. I didn't kick you with nobody else. I waited until I got to you in front of your face, and then I addressed how I felt about your wardrobe.
But you threw it out like a little side jet. Like, you came up behind me and snuck me right quick. Like, that wasn't no.
How was I supposed to feel?
You could have came to me, and furthermore, I'm not the one that said nothing about either? Your wardrobe. That was. So when Devin that brought that shit up, I just.
But
didn't
did
know.
You have something to say behind it, though? You did.
I didn't have a thing to say. I don't.
Oh, we're going to have to roll that beautiful bean foot.
And then how is she going to say somebody talking about somebody with that dress? Did you see her panties were showing?
Like, come on now. Ooh. Like, see-through and everything. Like, no.
That's some fiction.
Well, that dress didn't require drawers.
She did. And you got the nerve to talk about what I got going on. Absolutely. You need to be worried about yourself, sweetie.
Listen, matters the difference. However you feel about the situation, we're supposed to be better than that. And I feel like I'm more than an apology, baby. Like, what's up?
I definitely feel like I owe an apology. If anything, I feel like you owe me an apology.
So you don't feel like you owe me an apology?
No, I feel like you owe me an apology.
Chelsea, for real?
No, absolutely not.
You don't have to fuck this shit. I'm not going to go. Because you're not about
to sit up here. But you're not taking accountability for what you did.
You're not taking accountability. You got to take ownership.
No, I said blatantly. The world saw me say what I had to say, and I meant that.
I'm not giving you a moment, bro.
But you're not taking accountability for what you said.
What I'm not about to do is keep going back and forth with Chelsea over this tit for tat shit. She owes me an apology, and that's just how I feel about it. Like, if you go back and look at the tape, you know, I had my words I had to say, but I'm not the one that came for her. You know what I'm saying? She the one that sought out to come for me. So that's where the apology needs to come from, sweetie.
I'm confused.
Come on.
I'm lost.
Yeah, y'all doing too much.
No, but did she go on Twitter? And she went out and said she had to say on Twitter. She
what
hit
you
me.
Said? What you said at the reunion? You gotta understand that. Y'all equally did wrong. Both of y'all owed her apology.
I can eat that, but if you gonna take accountability, then I'll take accountability.
Y'all both should have just at that second said, "Okay, we both wrong." Somebody said,
"Oh, well,
she said we both."
Then tell her she wrong too. Tell her she tell me sorry. I tell her sorry.
That's wrong, man. That's
the problem. I'm kissing no bitch ass. I'm sorry.
This is what happens when bitches are not A1 from day one. When you don't remember the bullshit that you do and you try to play the victim, this is the prime example of what happens, sis. Take accountability. I said what I said. You didn't give me a moment. I already had my moment.
Hey, boo, you okay?
Hey, no, not really.
So what's going on? How are you feeling?
What you mean what's going on? Like, I'm really pissed off about that shit. Like, Chelsea is my homegirl. She is my friend.
Yeah, I know.
You know what I'm saying? I'm genuinely, like, my feelings is hurt because I would never say no shit like that about you. Like, she knows what I've been through, like, growing up in New Orleans as a kid. Like, I had to wear the same clothes all the time, and now I'm an adult. Like, don't do that. You bringing up childhood trauma and shit like that. I don't like that shit. Like, she materialistic. She selfish. She owed me a fucking apology, period.
Well, I gotta stand on Chelsea's side on this one now. I don't think that she's materialistic at all. I just feel like Chelsea is just, she's on a different status, I would have to say. And I guess she's just not used to hanging around people that don't live her lifestyle.
Bitch, you way too comfortable with trying to put me down and yourself down. Bitch, I'm greatness. I'm great. And I'm on a whole another different caliber, too. You should feel the same way about yourself, ho.
Lifestyle?
Yeah.
Status?
Yeah.
Bitch, so you basically sitting up here calling me a fucking peasant. Like, what type
I'm not calling you a peasant. Is that? I don't yes appreciate the fact you that you're calling me a bitch. I'm yes over here trying to have a conversation
with you.
With
your raggedy clothes, having you. Ass. You a fucking peasant, bitch.
Baby, I shop at American Eagle, Hollister. I shop at all of those label places, baby.
Tonight, after consultation with medical experts, the DFW Hospital Council, and the persons who prepare the North Texas Mass Critical Care Plan for both pediatrics and adults, I announce to you a difficult decision, but one based on science. Dallas County will move to a safer at home order. This is also known as a shelter in place order. This order is our best chance to flatten the curve here in Dallas County and save as many lives as possible.